Hello everybody, myself V. Narayana Babu, lecturer in Mathematics, GSI PU College, Mysore. In the last session, I have discussed property 5 and property 6 of the determinants. Today, let us solve the problems on the properties of determinants. So, let me recall the properties of the determinants. So, property 1. So, property 1 states that if in a determinant all the rows and columns are interchanged, then the value of the determinant remains unaltered. So, property 2 states that if in a determinant any two rows or columns are interchanged, then the value of the determinant changes by sign. Property 3 states that if in a determinant any two rows or columns are identical, then the value of the determinant becomes 0. Property 4 states that if in a determinant a row or a column is multiplied by a constant, then the whole determinant is multiplied by the same constant. Property 5 states that if a row or a column in a determinant can be expressed as sum of two terms, then the whole determinant can be expressed as sum of two determinants. And property 6 states that if in a determinant a row or column is multiplied by a constant and added to its corresponding row or column, then the value of the determinant remains same. Let us solve the problems on properties of determinants. Using the property of determinants, and without expanding, prove that first problem, determinant of x, a, x plus a, y, b, y plus b, z, c, z plus c will be equal to 0. Solution. Let us consider the LHS of the given problem. LHS equals determinant of x, a, x plus a, y, b, y plus b, z, c, z plus c. So now, here I use the column operation, that is c1 can be replaced by c1 plus c2. So that becomes, so here change is taking place in C1. So we have x plus a, y plus b, z plus c. That is C1 plus C2. And remaining columns write as it is. If you observe here, C1 and C3 are identical. So, we know that if any two rows or columns are identical, then the value of the determinant becomes 0. In this problem, C1 and C3 are identical. Therefore, the value of the determinant becomes 0. that is because C1 and C3 are identical. Or LHS equals determinant of XA, X plus A, Y, B, Y plus B, Z, C, Z plus C. See here, the third column is sum of two terms. The third column is sum of two terms. So, this can be expressed as sum of two determinants, that is determinant of X, A, X, Y, B, Y, Z, C, Z plus determinant of X, A, Y, B, B, Z, C, C. In the first determinant, we can see that C1 and C3 are identical. In the second determinant, C2 and C3 are identical. So, this will be equal to 0 plus 0, because in the first determinant C1 and C3 are identical. C1 and C3 are identical. Also, in the second determinant, C2 will be equal to C3. So, that will be equal to 0, which is equal to RHS. Second problem, prove that determinant of A minus B, B minus C, C minus A, B minus C, C minus A, A minus B, C minus A, A minus B, B minus C, that will be equal to 0. Solution. So, LHS is equal to determinant of A minus B, B minus C, C minus A, B minus C, C minus A, A minus B, C minus A, A minus B, B minus C. Here, either you can add all the columns or you can add all the rows. So, applying R1 as R1 plus R2 plus R3, that will be equal to determinant of, so I am adding R1 plus R2 and plus R3, that is A minus B plus B minus C plus C minus A. Here, B minus C plus C minus A plus A minus B. Next, C minus A plus A minus B plus B minus C. That means I am adding R2 and R3 to R1. So the change is taking place in R1. Remaining rows we have to write as it is. B minus C, C minus A minus B, C minus A minus B, B minus C. So now A get cancels, B minus B plus B minus C plus C. All terms will get cancelled. B minus B minus C minus A plus A. Now C minus B plus B minus A plus A. So all the terms will get cancelled. So that will be equal to determinant of 0, 0, 0, B minus C, C minus A minus B, C minus A minus B, B minus C. See, here the elements in the row 1 are all zeros. Therefore, the value of the determinant becomes 0, which will be equal to RHS. Next problem, problem number 3. Prove that determinant of 2, 7, 65. 3, 8, 75, 5, 9, 86 will be equal to 0. So LHS is equal to determinant of 2, 7, 65, 3, 8, 75, 5, 9, 86. So applying C1 as C1 plus 9 times C2, that is equal to determinant of, so here the change is taking place in C1. So here it is 2 plus 9 into 7, 3 plus 9 into 8, 5 plus 9 into 9. This is the first column. Now it has been changed. Next column will be 7, 8, 9. It is as it is. Third column also remains as it is. 86. So here I am using the property 6, that is, if in a row or a column a constant is multiplied to a row or a column and added to its corresponding row or column, then the value of the determinant remains unaltered, or it remains same. So that will be equal to determinant of 2 plus 9 sevens are 63, 3 plus 9 eights are 72, 5 plus 9 nines are 81, 7, 8, 9. 65, 75, 86. So that will be equal to determinant of 65, 75, 86, 7, 8, 9, 65, 75, 86. So if you observe this determinant, here the column 1 and column 3 are identical. So we know that if any two rows or columns are identical, then the value of the determinant becomes 0. So this will be equal to 0 because C1 and C3 are identical. That will be equal to RHS. So next problem, prove that determinant of 1 BC A into B plus C 1 CA B into C plus A 1 AB C into A plus B will be equal to 0. Solution. So LHS is equal to determinant of 1 BC A into B plus C 1 CA B into C plus A 1 AB to C into A plus B. So which will be equal to determinant of 1 BC, I multiply A to the factor B plus C. So we have AB plus AC 1 CA B into C plus B into A 1 AB, so it is CA plus CB. So applying C3 by C3 plus C2. So applying C3 by C3 plus C2. That means we are adding C3 and C2. So we get here the change has been taken place in C3. So first column remains as it is BC CA AB. Even second column also remains as it is. Now C3 has been replaced by C3 plus C2, that is AB plus AC plus BC. So we have AB plus AC plus BC. Here BC plus BA plus CA. Here CA plus CB plus AB. So here in the third column all the elements are AB plus AC plus BC. So we can take it as common AB plus BC plus CA. If we take common, we have determinant of 1, 1, 1, BC, CA, AB. Here we get 1, 1, 1. So, in this determinant, C1 and C3 are identical. So, AB plus BC plus CA into 0 because C1 and C3 are identical. So AB plus BC plus CA into 0, we get 0, which is nothing but RHS. Okay. Thank you.